brought to you by GTA. We start with you.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
The hearing follows the recent and historic visit to Micronesia by Secretary of State Mike Pompeo. He announced the start of consultations ahead of the renegotiation of the Compacts of Free Association, which expire in 2023. Congressman Brad Sherman of California says the importance of the Pacific Islands should never be understated.
Despite these historic ties, we have heard from FAS leaders that all too often it seems the United States has drifted away. Too often our policy seems to be on autopilot.
Funding, of course, will be a key issue as annual grant money will dry up and the trust funds that were meant to create economic self-sufficiency are falling well short.
We must get ahead of the issue. And that is one of the reasons we're holding this hearing, to get all of our colleagues in Congress to focus on the importance of the freely associated states.
And looming large over the talk, says ranking Republican Representative Ann Wagner,
China has already begun to pressure Pacific Island countries in an attempt to push the borders of its sphere of influence.
Further underscoring the talks is the creation of the first ever Pacific Islands Congressional Caucus led by Hawaii's Ed Case, who raised a critical concern that's shared by Guam, the cost of hosting FAS migrants.
The impact of the compacts thus far on specific jurisdictions in our country are not acceptable anymore. And I speak primarily of the locations where the compact migrants come to. These are Guam, these are Sinai to some extent, certainly Hawaii.
Trump administration officials say a compact negotiator has not yet been decided, but FSM ambassador to the U.S., Aquilino Susaya, says when the negotiations do get underway,
I wish on behalf of the FSM to ask that the review and approval process, knowing how the legislative process in the Congress plays, that it be done on a timely and expeditious basis.
For Guam's News Network, I'm Nestor Lakanto.
Brought to you by GTA. We start with you.